Hi, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. We will first see how consumers and producers gain a surplus in a transaction. We will then analyze in detail the surplus of producers. Finally, we will see how this surplus evolves depending on market power. Consumers and producers gain a welfare out of a transaction. In general, consumers get to consume a product. Producers get to gain money. In a model of supply and demand, this welfare corresponds to a surplus. A surplus is the welfare gained by an agent, part in a transaction. In general, for consumers, it is the utility derived from the consumption of the good. For producers, it is the money gained through the difference between the price the company is willing to sell its products for and the actual price the consumer pays. This is the standard supply and demand model. The global surplus is modeled as the orange area. The surplus of the consumer is the upper part of the triangle. The surplus of the producer is the lower part of the triangle. Let's focus on the surplus of the producer. It varies depending on the structure of the market. Regulators will focus on it a lot. Indeed, this is because the producer surplus may be expended in a situation where a firm uses its position on a market to make extra profits, sometimes referred to as a rent. We will come back to it. The more its position on the market is strong, the bigger its market power. There are several types of market structures. They are defined by the degree of concentration of producers. If there is an infinite amount of producers on a perfectly functioning market, one will talk about a perfectly competitive market. If there is a finite number of competitors selling differentiated products, we will talk about monopolistic competition. With few competitors, the rise in market power gives way to an oligopoly. With a single producer, this is a monopoly. Let's analyze the supply and demand model with market power. For the standard supply and demand model, there is perfect competition. When a firm gains market power, for instance, when a market transforms from a monopolistic competition into an oligopoly, it can increase its prices and decrease the quantity it produces. The supply curve will move up. This will induce shortages in quantity and an increase in prices. How will the global surplus evolve? It used to be this area. It is now this area. The global surplus has diminished. This used to be the surplus of the consumer. It has now decreased in size. This used to be the surplus of the producer. The new producer surplus corresponds to this area between the price and the new supply curve. This area is both lost for the producer and for the consumer. It is a deadweight loss, a loss in global surplus. It represents the share of global welfare that is lost because the market does not achieve equilibrium. We can also represent the perceived demand from the perspective of the firm. In a perfectly competitive market, the firm cannot change the price. If it changes the quantity sold, the price will be the same. In a monopolistic competition, changes in price are translated into more or less quantity sold, but the relationship is weak. In an oligopoly, the relationship between price and quantity is stronger in terms of perceived demand. Any changes in price will correspond to important changes in quantity sold. This is because the oligopolists or price makers, they can change prices, and these changes will have an impact on perceived demand. This leads us to common mistakes made about market structures and services. First mistake, there are perfectly competitive markets. In reality, all markets are imperfect and have a finite number of producers. This is referred to as a monopolistic competition. Second common mistake, all monopolies are bad for the economy. In reality, the existence of a monopoly may be the only way for a market to be viable. The question is then how it should be regulated by the state so as to minimize the decrease in global surplus. Time for a quick exercise. Calculate the producer surplus. Let's assume that the equilibrium price is $10 and the equilibrium quantity 20 units. We must calculate the producer surplus, all things being equal. Is it $0, $100, or $200? Here is the producer surplus visualized. It is equal to the equilibrium price multiplied by the equilibrium quantity divided by 2. In this case, $10 multiplied by 20 units equal 200 divided by 2 equal $100. Answer 2, $100. A quick recap. We have seen in this class that the model of supply and demand allows to identify the global surplus, the consumer surplus, and the producer surplus. The producer surplus varies depending on the market structure. The more oligopolistic or monopolistic a market is, the higher the producer surplus will be. Thanks for watching. Check out Chegg for more resources on macroeconomics.